how to add custom backgrounds for your levels in Super Mario Concert version 8 and beyond. I already made one in my own channel a few years ago, but that was for a much older version, and up until today, a lot has changed, mainly due to how the editor looks right now. It got a complete visual overhaul. However, the principle of adding a custom background in itself is still the same. So to start off, your custom background must have the size of 1024 by 864 pixels or 512 by 432 pixels. And you will have to upload it on an online image hosting website. There are multiple options for this step, but even after all this time, we still recommend imager.com for this because it does not require you to create an account and because uploading an image there is simply very quick and easy to do. Once you're on Imager, go to the top left and hit this new post button. Now, either drag and drop or select the custom background you want to upload right on this window. Once this is done, wait a few seconds for the site to generate a readable URL for your custom background. Then right-click on the image and select Copy Image URL. If you're not comfortable with actually designing your very own custom background, that's okay, as one of our community members created a website containing over 1500 custom backgrounds uploaded by our community over time for you to choose from. If you're going to use a background from this site, simply copy the link in front of the URL text piece, captioned below the custom background. Make sure that the URL you copy ends in .png or .jpeg, whatever is the image format of your background, from either Imager or whichever website you're using to host the custom background, which also includes the Level ShareSquare custom background database, though that hasn't released yet as of posting this video. Once you have your background URL, our next step is to head over to Super Mario Construct and jump into the editor, right on the level you're working on. Once you're inside the editor, click on the gear icon at the bottom, and then, on the left sidebar, click on the icon with the red sky, Customize Backgrounds. It will already put you on the background tab by default, which is where you will add the custom background. Now click on this window right here. It will say Edit Background when you hover the cursor over it. Click on that and scroll all the way down this menu until you see a square with the text Custom Background. Click on that, and just like how it says in the menu, simply go to this bracket and paste the URL you copied, and BAM! Your custom background is now added! And as you saw, you can also upload custom foregrounds. The way you add them is exactly the same as adding custom backgrounds, except the image format for these must strictly be .png, as this format guarantees to save transparency. If your foreground does not have transparency, it will look something like this. Simply save these in the PNG format, so you will be able to see your beautiful background, and not just a chunk of white. If you just want to add one foreground, uploading it on either of the foreground or middle ground tab is the same. But if you want to use two foregrounds, keep in mind that whatever is chosen or uploaded on the foreground tab will appear in front of what's selected in the middle ground tab. Just a friendly reminder. You will be thrilled after knowing that you can also make your own animated custom backgrounds in Super Mario Construct, as this became possible in version 8. Be aware though, because this type of background is a lot more tricky to work with than still backgrounds, and the method that I have previously shown in this video for still backgrounds does not work at all. Not to worry though, because this is where I share you the one method to add animated custom backgrounds in Super Mario Construct. As long as you pay very, very close attention to all of the steps. Are you ready? Alright, follow my lead and learn how to make this beautiful feature come to life in your levels. Starting off, your image file must have an exact size of 512 by 432 pixels, once again. And it has to be a .webm file, with the help of a file converter. No GIFs and no other animation files. It really has to be strictly in the .webm format, just to be extra clear and to really ensure that this will also work for you. So that's the technical side all worked out, but how do we actually get or make these animated backgrounds? And where should we upload them? Well, to be completely honest, that's the hardest and most boring step here, because I couldn't really find any place or website where you can get pre-animated backgrounds, as you have to take into account of the specific size that SMC requires. So in general, your best bet here is to animate the background yourself. Now don't worry, I will also show you how to do that too. Animated backgrounds are comprised of multiple still images, which are generally called frames. One really nice place to get 16-bit style backgrounds with included frames for animation is spritersresource.com. It includes graphics from thousands upon thousands of retro games, including, of course, Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis Mega Drive games. There's only so many options and themes to browse through here, so you're very likely not to run out of choices. Aight, once you pick your desired background sheet, it's time to bring it over to your image editing software of choice. I'm using PaintNet here, but you can use any other image editor, like Photoshop and even Microsoft Paint, since we're just cropping and moving images here. What we're gonna do here is to open as many 512 by 432 pixel sized canvases as there are frames on your selected background sheet. In my case here, I open 3 new canvases, or project files if you will, as there is a total of 3 animation frames. And basically, we will copy and paste each frame to each canvas, and save them separately as single image files. You can save them in any image format of your choice, as long as they can be exported to be used for GIF making. Yes, GIF making for now, because it's simpler to combine all of our separated frames into one GIF file first, and then convert said GIF to the .webm format. There's tons of places on the internet where you can create a GIF with your frames, but I recommend using one particular website for this step, which is easygif.com, because it's bundled with some pretty nice options, like the ones I'm about to show you. First off, we're clicking on the Choose Files button, and then bring our separated frames here. Hit this thick blue button, upload and make a GIF, and then EasyGIF lays out all of your selected frames like this, placing the one that was selected first on the left, and the last one selected at the very end. In here, you can drag any frame to any order of your liking, as well as to create copies of any of your frames by clicking on this blue little copy button. This is very useful for when you want to sustain a certain frame in the animation, like I have done with this background, where the mask's eyes glow for quite a bit. This red skip button simply excludes one frame from the animation. Moving down this page, we have toggle a range of frames, which basically allows you to select the start and end of the animation by inputting the number assigned to whichever frame, as already conveniently labeled by EasyGIF. Further below, the only other option you need to take into account is delay time, which determines the speed of your animation. The lower the number, the faster your animation will play. The higher the number, the slower... Yeah, you should be smart enough to figure this one by now. These other options can be ignored, so let's go ahead and hit this saucy Make a GIF button to render our GIF file. Once that is done, it's time to convert this GIF to the long-awaited .webm format. Luckily, EasyGIF also allows us to convert GIFs to WebMs too. I'll also leave in the description the links for EasyGIF's GIF Maker and File Converter. Why did I do that? Because I like you a lot. Anyway, just import our recently rendered GIF animation, then simply hit the upload button down below. After this is processed, it will display our animation in the GIF format. All there is left to do is to hit convert to WebM format and boom! Congratulations, because you, my friends, have just created yourselves your very own WebM animation. The final step before bringing it to Super Mario Construct is to host it somewhere online. As of now, the game recognizes WebM links from Dropbox and FileGarden, the latter being quicker and easier to use, so let's upload our WebM file over there. Once you have created or have logged in with your FileGarden account, simply hit the orange upload button and select your rendered WebM here. The animated custom background is swiftly imported, and FileGarden automatically prepares a readable URL for you to copy. Just select your uploaded WebM here, and copy the generated URL over here at the far right, by clicking this little button. As for the privacy setting, leave this as unlisted. All there is left to do is to bring our URL to the game. This part of the process is the exact same as uploading a still custom background, and simply go to this bracket, and paste the URL you have copied for your very own animated custom background! Alright, here's the real final step. Sit back and appreciate the animation playing in the horizon, overseeing your level. I want you to give yourself a pat in the back for making this view possible, because it really is awesome seeing something we put our hard effort into come to life. And that is how you add custom backgrounds, custom foregrounds, and custom animated backgrounds to Super Mario Construct. If you liked what this game has to offer, and if this video has helped you, leave a like and subscribe to our channel, as we announce new updates, streams, and tutorials for the games in our website, Level Share Square. That is levelchefsquare.com. See you next time. Bye-bye.